everyone. Hello, welcome back to Weekly Korean Live Class, and my name is Kaejin. 안녕하세요, Kaejin입니다. And 침침입니다. 침침입니다. So thank you for waiting for this lesson, everyone. I already see your comments, and today, yes, we are going to talk about Korean adjective. I can write it here, right? Korean adjective. And maybe I can write it in Korean too, which is 형용사. 형용사. So adjective in Korean is 형용사. 형용사. 안녕하세요, Peter. And Ladiaka, Acid Gray, Sam Lady, Jeff, Beyond the Scene, Tabumaster, Baba, and Saina, Mr. Mint Green. Ooh, nice. Please keep using your YouTube nickname in Korean. That makes me easy to read your name. And Mr. Chim Chim here too. Same. Rihanna and Wellington, 안녕하세요. And Sadia Gil, you are here as usual. So how's the weather in your country right now? Korea is getting cooler, and we can say 시원하다. 시원하다 meaning cool. So Korean weather in Korea is 시원하다. 시원하다. It's a dictionary form, so if you want to say, if you want to change it to the spoken form, you can say 시원해요. 시원해요. 요새 한국 날씨는 꽤 시원해요. Or for intermediate learners, advanced learners, there is another vocabulary for you, which is 선선하다. 선선하다. 선선하다 is so good. So there are two words, two adjectives to describe the weather in Korea right now. It's almost autumn. It's almost autumn. It's not yet. It's, I think the highest degree today is like 27 degrees in Seoul. So it's not very cold or not very cool, but it's getting cooler and cooler. So you can say the weather, especially at night, is pretty cool. So you can say 날씨가 시원해요. 시원해요. Or 날씨가 선선해요. 선선해요. The difference. 시원하다 can be used for other stuff too. For example, like cool tea. The tea is cold. In English, you say cold tea, but in Korea, we use this one. 시원한 차. 차가 시원해요. Or What else? Beer? Yes, beer. You can say 맥주가 시원해요. 맥주가 시원해요. 선선하다 is used for the weather, usually the temperature. It's not for food or it's not for something else. It's usually about the temperature of the weather. So at night, the weather, the temperature is cool. So 선선해요. 선선해요. Christina Guti, 여기 날씨가 필리핀에서 좋습니다. So Philippines weather is good now, right? 날씨가 좋아요. And Acid Gray, 날씨가 시원해요. Jeff, 날씨가 좋아요. Yes, that's great. So we usually, Acid Gray, we usually just say, oh, 시원해요. You don't have to put 날씨가 시원해요. So, okay, great. 제시카신 지금 시원해. It's cool right now. So I just introduced two words, right? 시원하다, 선선하다. Those are the adjectives. Those are the adjectives. I just wrote everything in Korean. So if you are not able to understand, click the link in the description. if you are on YouTube, the link will be below. And for Facebook people, the link will be above or here. So check it out. So if you click it, you will see the page like this. So don't forget to log in. So ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So it's very easy. There are a lot of information about Korean alphabet. Hangul. Hangul. So there's a free video. There's history of our Korean alphabet or the chart. Well, it's not very clear to see, but you can always click the link in the description. It's free, so check it out. This is Hangul chart. And then also my video. And then, yeah, lots of information here. The highlight here is this. If you click the download now button, this big blue button, you will get free Hangul alphabet sheet. So this is PDF, so you can download whenever you want and then just print it out. So you can practice writing like this. There are lots of writing practices, so please check it out. It's completely free, so I recommend. Ganesh, right? 네팔의 날씨도 선선해요. So you are in Nepal, right? And the weather is pretty cool. Great. Okay, so we just learned a few Korean adjective, and from now on, I'm going to introduce even more Korean adjective, which is 형용사, 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 형용사. Okay, so you might be wondering, what are adjective? What is adjective? What are you talking about? So, adjective is a word that describes things. Like, for example, for example, like expensive bag, or pretty woman, or cute chim-chim. So you describe thing, describe someone, describe item, describe place, anything. So that describe a noun, that's adjective. That gives extra information to the noun. So let's see an example. Yeah, expensive bag. Okay, so in English, you say, this bag is expensive. You can say that, right? This bag is expensive. So you usually put noun here, plus, verb here, and then this adjective here, right? This is how you write in English, right? It's pretty similar in Korean. It's not exactly 100% the same, but in Korea, for example, this bag is expensive is 이 Oh, it's not. Can you see this? 이 가방은 비싸다. 이 가방은 비싸다. 이 가방은 비싸다. 이 가방 is noun. And this 은 is particle. Particle is Korean grammar word you will need to learn, and I already explained these particles before, so check out my previous video. And then this adjective. So like this. So the order is pretty similar, right? So when you describe a noun, you put noun and then write verb or particle in Korean and then use the adjective. So this is a structure, right? So today I'll show you this structure today. Okay, and there's another way to use this adjective in English too, right? So how can you say expensive bag? Expensive bag is... Oops, do we have another pen? Expensive bag. Then you write the adjective here and then bag, noun. Same in Korean. In Korean, we also say 비싼 비싼 가방 비싼 가방. So 비싼 is an adjective. The world order is basically the same.
But
the word, the conjugation will be different. That's what I'm going to introduce in this lesson. Peter, 이 가방은 비싸요. Eliza, 이 가방은 비싸다. 비싼 가방. Ellen, 이 가방은 비싸다. Ellen, Pew, and Lusan, Jessica, Shin, Aaron. Great job. Great job. So, let's see. So these are the examples how adjectives are used in a sentence. And I'm going to introduce some common adjectives. So, as you can see, you just saw 비싼, right? 비싸다. 비싸다 means expensive. You might be using this when you travel to Korea. It's like you bought something, and then I don't know the living cost in your country, but if it's more expensive here in Korea, then you probably say, 비싸, 비싸요. So, 따란, expensive. So, how can you say expensive? The dictionary form is 비싸다, 비싸다. Dictionary form is 비싸다, 비싸다. And spoken form is 비싸. So this bag is expensive. Then you can say 이 가방 비싸. This is casual form, informal form. But if you want to say that to someone who you are not so close to or who is older than you, then you can put 요 at the end to make this sentence politer. 비싸요, 비싸요. 이 물은 비싸요. In some countries, I found water is more expensive than Korea. 비싸요. And just like I introduced before, these are used in a sentence, right? If you want to use it before noun, like it's not like this bag is expensive. You want to say expensive bag, then you have to use 비싼. 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 So why it become 비싼? From it was 비싸다 originally, but then it become 비싼, right? How does it work? How did you make it? So I'll show you how I made it. Ta-da-ran. So 비싸다. 비싸다 is a dictionary form. What's the stem of this word? Stem? Just remove that at the end. Then it become stem. And it ended with vowel. So we put 비싸, 비싼, 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 비싼. So it become 비싼. You just put this or 은. You will need to put this or this. But if this, the adjective stem ends with a vowel, then you just use sound. If this adjective stem ends with a consonant, then you will be using 은. I'll show you a lot of examples today, so don't worry about it. 비싼, 비싼. Then, how about cheap? Cheap. 비 actually from the Chinese character means no. It's negative. So, if you just remove 비, then it becomes the word. 싸다 is a dictionary form of cheap or written form. 싸다, 싸다. 싸 is spoken form. So, this clothes, this jacket is cheap. 싸, 이 자켓은 싸. Or politely, you can put 요, 요. Or this is a cheap coat. Then you can say 싼 코트, 싼 코트. Dictionary form, spoken form. So when you use the adjective before noun, it changed like this. Ta-da-da! Expensive and cheap. We just learned it, and there will be more adjectives. So How about this? Korean is difficult. Do you agree? I hope not. 어렵다. 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 It's a dictionary form of saying difficult. 어렵다. 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 Spoken form is 어려워. If you want to say it politely, put 요 at the end. So it will be 어려워요. 어려워요. Right, this is actually irregular verb. So the verb stem, the adjective stem ended with 비우. This, right? 비우. So we just put 우 instead of 비우. This, we put 우 and then 어. 우 어. So yes, this one. I'll give you another example. So 어려워. And then if you want to use it before noun, you will be 어려운. 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 Difficult. Ta-da-dum. Bye-bye, expensive. Now, difficult. Okay, so I'll show you how I made it. So, 어렵다, right? 어렵다. This is 비읍, 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 irregular verb. Remove it. And then instead of this, put this. And then put 어, because for you, if you learn the Korean conjugation, then you probably understand. This is not a or o sound, so we will use 어. If you are confused, check out my present tense conjugation lesson. So if it's a or o, then you will use a sound. Otherwise, you will use 어 sound. So we just put 어. And then this is 워, 워. So we combine it as this. 워, 워. Yes, some part of Korean grammar is difficult. But if you get used to it, it won't be very difficult. I learned English, right? Oh my god, English is so difficult. There are a lot of irregular rules. For example, like I teach Korean, I taught Korean. So it's not teached. You have to memorize, oh, it's taught Korean. Like, or I go to school, I went to school. It's not good. So in English, you memorized those irregular rules and then now you got used to it and it's not difficult at all, right? Same in Korean. So if you got used to it, it will be okay. So please practice a lot. When I introduce new words, you have to practice. Please keep writing with your mobile keyboard or just computer keyboard so you get used to the shape of the word or how to write it. So okay, so we have difficult. Then you have to talk about easy, right? Easy. Easy is 쉽다. 쉽다. 한국어는 쉬워요. Korean language is easy. 쉽다. Spoken form? 쉬워. It ended with 비읍, right? So we remove it and then put 우, 우, and then put 어, 어, 어. So it's 쉬워. But 쉬워, 쉬워. If you pronounce it quickly, then it becomes 쉬워, 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 쉬워. And 요 at the end. 요, 쉬워요. If you want to use this adjective before noun, then you have to say 쉬운. So easy Korean is 쉬운 한국어. 쉬운 한국어. 한국어는 쉬워요. Korean language is easy. I hope. So, since we just talked about the 비읍 irregular verb, I'll introduce one more. Hot, hot, hot is 덥다, 덥다. It's a dictionary form. 덥다, 덥다 is hot. We don't use this word for hot soup or hot tea, hot coffee, we don't say this word for the things. This one is only for the weather. 덥다, 덥다 is only for weather. 더워, 더워. 덥다. 더워. Same. Remove 비읍 at the end, in from the verbs, adjective stem, and then put 우, 어. 더워, 더워, 더워. If you want to say politely, put 요. 더워요. Want to use this use this word before noun, then you have to say 더운, 더운. Please remember, this one is only for the temperature, the weather. So it's not for the hot tea, hot soup, hot cocoa. It's only for the weather. Hot. Then, how about cold? Again, this one is not for food. This one is for weather. 춥다. 춥다. Spoken form, 추워. Remove 비읍 and then put 우어, 추워. 추워. If you want to say politely, put 요. So it will be 추워요. Elijah, Angela, is it a great? Tab Master Baba, Kristen, S, Lania, Sketchy, Jessica Shin, Ellen, Pew, Nant, Napak. Great job. Please keep typing, okay? 추워요. If you want to use this adjective before noun, then say 추운. 한국은 추운 나라예요. Korea is a cold country. 추운 나라. 추운 나라예요. Not always. In the winter, it's very cold. So, 추운, 추운. Then you might be wondering, then what if I want to say cold beer or like cold something or hot tea, hot soup? Then you will use this. 뜨겁다. 뜨겁다. This one is for temperature of something. This water is so hot. 이 물이 뜨거워요. 뜨겁다. Or the water is cold. 차갑다. Can say 아, 차가워. 차가워요. 차갑다. So this one is for temperature of things and this one is for the weather. All good? Okay, so next one. Next, I prepare this right. The reason why I prepare this, because you will use a lot when you take an exam. So this question is correct, or you get this question correct or incorrect. 맞다. 맞다 means right. Oh, you're right. Oh, 맞아요. 맞아요. So spoken form is 맞아. To speak politely, put 요 at the end. But this one is casual, informal form. 맞아요. 맞아요. And 맞은. 맞은. Okay. All good. Right. Correct. Ooh. Oops. 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 Yes. And then how about this? Da-da-da, wrong. I got it wrong. 이 문제 틀렸어요. 틀리다. 틀리다. Oh, I got it wrong. 틀리다. Do you know the answer? Oh, I think I just said that, right? 틀려요. So, oh, you said something like, oh, I think Chimchim is the most beautiful doll in the world. And you want to say, that's wrong. You can say, 틀려. 아니야, 틀려. 아니야. 틀려. Or 틀려요, politely. And then 틀린, if you want to use this adjective before noun, you can say 틀린, chilling. And I have fun word. fun word, which is 재미있다. 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 재미 means fun. 재미 means fun. And 있다, 있다 means exist. So 재미있다 literally means fun exist. Fun exist. 재미있다. And then you can say 재미있어. For example, you watch a lot of YouTube videos, right? So, 유튜브 비디오는 재미있어. 유튜브 비디오는 재미있어. 유튜브 동영상은 재미있어. 유튜브 영상은 재미있어. So there are a lot of ways to say video in Korean. 동영상, 영상, or video. To speak politely, you can say this. This movie is fun. 이 영화는 재미있어요. 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 Or you can say fun movie. 재미있는, 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 재미있는. Oh, Pew Pwing, great job! You got the answer even before I introduced this. All correct. Good job. Awesome. Then how about boring? Boring is opposite word of fun, right? You can say 재미 없다. Again, 재미 means fun. 없다 means doesn't exist, don't have. So fun doesn't exist, which is boring, right? 재미없다, 재미없다. You can say, this movie was boring. 재미없어. Oh, 이 영화 진짜 재미없어. Meaning, this movie is really boring. 재미없어. Speak politely, you can put 요 at the end. 요 at the end. 재미없어요, 재미없어요. Boring movie. Boring movie is 재미없는 영화. 재미없는 영화. Boring, boring. And since we are almost ending, I lastly prepared some tricky word. Good. Good. 좋다. 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 Well, this school is good. Then you can say 좋아. 이 학교 좋아. 이 학교 좋아. 이 학교는 좋아. 좋아 means good. Put you, then it become polite, right? 좋아요. 이 학교는 좋아요. 이 학교 좋아요. This school is good. Good school. 좋은 학교. Or this company is good. 좋은 회사. 좋은 회사. Good friends. 좋은 친구. 좋은 친구. So good is 좋다. 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 따라란. Good. Then bad. Bad, right? Bad. 나쁘다. Bad is 나쁘다, 나쁘다. So if you want to say this school is bad, then you can say 나빠, 이 학교 나빠. Or 나빠요, to speak politely. And bad school. 나쁜 학교, 나쁜 학교. But the reason why I said this is tricky is it's not exactly same as the bad in English. By the way, Jeff, Belisa, O'Keefe, 감사합니다, 선생님. 감사합니다, 우리 이쁜 학생. Jeff씨, 고마워요. Thank you for your donation, and I hope you learned a lot from this lesson. So, the reason why bad is tricky is different from English bad. For example, if you say the school is bad, then you probably think, oh, the quality of school is not very good, right? But if you use this Korean word 나쁜 학교, it sounds like the school did bad thing. Maybe the school treats students badly, they hit students, or teachers say bad words. It sounds like they are doing something incorrect, inappropriate things. It's, they are not talking about the quality, but it's more like moral thing. So if you say bad friend, 나쁜 친구, it sounds like the friends are maybe always like smoking at school, drinking. It sounds like it's not exactly about quality. For example, I drew it. Hey guys, look at my picture. This is mountain and this is sun, road. Isn't it amazing? And you want to say, your drawing is so bad. You don't use this word. It's not about quality. You just say, "별로다." Is actually indirect way to say not good, but it's 별로다. 잘 못 그리는구나. Oh, you are not drawing very well. But this, if you say 나쁜 그림, 나쁜 means bad, and 그림 means drawing. And if you say 나쁜 그림, it sounds like I drawed something incorrect. Like maybe I was drawing my friend's face so bad. 나쁜, it sounds like something incorrect, you know, prepared. So it's not exactly same as bad in English. And 종민이 love you. What's the difference between 나쁜 and 나빠? 나쁜. 나쁜 is used before noun. So for example, 나쁜 사람, bad person. 나쁜 사람. But you want to say 저 사람은 means that person is bad. 나빠. 나빠. So 나빠 is used in a sentence, noun plus a particle and this adjective, but 나쁜 is used before nouns to describe this noun. 나쁜 사람. It's like bad person, the person is bad. So is it okay? So we are almost time. I hope you learned a lot. And if you like this lesson, please don't forget to give us like. The reason why I talk about like is in Korean, like is 좋아요. So you press like button on YouTube video, on Facebook video, and Instagram, right? The like button in Korean is 좋아요 button. So don't forget to give us like so I can make more videos for you every Thursday. So like. And also, if you are not able to read all this Hangul is so easy to learn. So check out our free cheat sheet. Free Hangul writing sheet. You can download for free by clicking the link in the description below or above or around this video. So it's completely free. This is downloadable PDF. So you can download and print it out and write it down. There are a lot, right? So you can practice every day. There are some words and quizzes too. So Korean is so easy to learn. Korean alphabet is so easy. So you can master in a few hours. So check it out. Don't postpone it. Just try today or this weekend so you can learn even more Korean with me next week. Next week's topic will be how to stay motivated. Heart. So when you learn a language, you sometimes feel tired and then you got sick and tired of language learning, so you want to stop learning Korean, right? I hope you don't feel like that way, but I know there are some learners, so I prepared some of the ways to help you stay motivated to keep learning Korean. So please join this lesson. It will be October 10th. Yay! On Thursday, as usual, it will be 1 p.m. in Korean time. So please join this lesson again, and I'll be waiting for you. So thank you very much, Pew, Print, Ellen, Robel, Wilma, Wellington, Peter, Chayla, Dako, and Jeff. 치아라, 다코, 방탄 아미 걸, 앤 S 라니아 키에, 다브 마스터, 바바이 리안나, 종민이 러브, 이스프리, 브리안나. So thank you very much. Oh, 다브 마스터 바바. So you took 2 hours to master this Korean alphabet. That's awesome. And then Chiara took me 2 days to learn Korean alphabet. Right, you have to memorize all. So see, it wouldn't take 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Of course, it depends on your concentration level. So, but one thing that I can tell you is Korean alphabet is so easy. So check out the link in the description and I'll see you next week. Thank you, Amanda and Rihanna and Porsche. Gracias, Ruslelo, Philip. Bye-bye.